November 24th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, Ezekiel chapters 23 and 24 from the Old Testament. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, there were two women who were daughters of the same mother. They engaged in prostitution in Egypt. In their youth, they engaged in prostitution. Their breasts were squeezed there. Lovers fondled their virgin nipples there. Oholah was the name of the older, and Oholabah the name of her younger sister. They became mine and gave birth to sons and daughters. Oholah is Samaria, and Oholabah is Jerusalem. Oholah engaged in prostitution while she was mine. She lusted after her lovers, the Assyrians, warriors, clothed in blue, governors and officials, all of them desirable young men, horsemen riding on horses. She bestowed her sexual favors on them. All of them were the choicest young men of Assyria. She defiled herself with all whom she desired, with all their idols. She did not abandon the prostitution she had practiced in Egypt, for in her youth men had sex with her, fondled her virgin breast, and ravished her. Therefore I handed her over to her lovers, the Assyrians for whom she lusted. They exposed her nakedness, seized her sons and daughters, and killed her with a sword. She became notorious among women, and they executed judgments against her. Her sister Oholabah watched this, but she became more corrupt in her lusts than her sister had been, and her acts of prostitution were more numerous than those of her sister. She lusted after the Assyrians, governors and officials, warriors in full armor, horsemen riding on horses, all of them desirable young men. I saw that she was defiled. Both of them followed the same path. But she increased her prostitution. She saw men carved on the wall, images of the Chaldeans carved in bright red, wearing belts on their waist and flowing turbans on their heads, all of them looking like officers, the image of Babylonians whose native land is Chaldea. When she saw them, she lusted after them and sent messengers to them in Chaldea. The Babylonians crawled into bed with her. They defiled her with their lust. After she was defiled by them, she became disgusted with them. When she lustfully exposed her nakedness, I was disgusted with her, just as I had been disgusted with her sister. Yet she increased her prostitution, remembering the days of her youth when she engaged in prostitution in the land of Egypt. She lusted after their genitals as large as those of donkeys, and their seminal emissions was as strong as that of stallions. This is how you assess the obscene conduct of your youth, when the Egyptians fondled your nipples and squeezed your young breast. Therefore, Oholabah, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Look here, I'm about to stir up against you the lovers with whom you were disgusted. I will bring them against you from every side, the Babylonians and all the Chaldeans, Pekod, Shoah, and Koah, and all the Assyrians with them, desirable young men, all of them governors and officials, officers and nobles, all of them riding on horses. They will attack you with weapons, chariots, wagons, and with a huge army. They will array themselves against you on every side with large shields, small shields, and helmets. I will assign them the task of judgment. They will punish you according to their laws. I will direct my jealous anger against you, and they will deal with you in rage. They will cut off your nose and your ears, and your survivors will die by the sword. They will seize your sons and daughters, and your survivors will be consumed by fire. They will strip your clothes off and take away your beautiful jewelry. So I will put an end to your obscene conduct and your prostitution, which you have practiced in the land of Egypt. You will not seek their help or remember Egypt any more. For this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Look here, I am about to deliver you over to those whom you hate, to those with whom you were disgusted. They will treat you with hatred. Take away all you have labored for and leave you naked and bare. Your nakedness will be exposed, just as when you engage in prostitution and obscene conduct. I will do these things to you because you engaged in prostitution with the nations, polluting yourself with their idols. You have followed the ways of your sister, so I will place her cup of judgment in your hand. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. You will drink your sister's deep and wide cup. You will be scorned and derided, for it holds a great deal. You will be overcome by drunkenness and sorrow. The cup of your sister Samaria is a cup of horror and desolation. You will drain it dry, gnaw its pieces, and tear out your breast. For I have spoken, declares the Sovereign Lord. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Because you have forgotten me and completely disregarded me, you must bear now the punishment for your obscene conduct and prostitution. The Lord said to me, Son of man, are you willing to pronounce judgment on Oholah and Oholibah? Then declare to them their abominable deeds. For they have committed adultery, and blood is on their hands. They have committed adultery with their idols and their sons, whom they bore to me. They have passed through the fire as food to their idols. Moreover, they have done this to me. In the very same day they desecrated my sanctuary and profaned my Sabbaths. On the same day they slaughtered their sons for their idols. They came to my sanctuary to desecrate it. This is what they have done in the middle of my house. They even sent for men from far away. When the messenger arrived, those men set out. For them you bathed, painted your eyes, and decorated yourself with jewelry. You sat on a magnificent couch with table arranged in front of it, where you placed my incense and my olive oil. The sound of a carefree crowd accompanied her, including all kinds of men. Even Sabaeans were brought from the desert. The sisters put bracelets on their wrists and beautiful crowns on their heads. Then I said about the one worn out by adultery, now they will commit immoral acts with her. They had sex with her as one does with a prostitute. In this way they had sex with Oholah and Oholibah, promiscuous women. But upright men will punish them appropriately for their adultery and bloodshed, because they are adulteresses and blood is on their hands. For this is what the Sovereign Lord says, bring up an army against them and subject them to terror and plunder. That army will pelt them with stones and slash them with their swords. They will kill their sons and daughters and burn their houses. I will put an end to the obscene conduct in the land. All the women will learn a lesson from this and not engage in obscene conduct. They will repay you for your obscene conduct, and you will be punished for idol worship. Then you will know that I am the Sovereign Lord. The word of the Lord came to me in the 9th year, in the 10th month, on the 10th day of the month. Son of man, write down the name of this day, this very day. The king of Babylon has laid siege to Jerusalem this very day. Recite a proverb to this rebellious house and say to them, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Set on the pot, set it on, pour water in it too. Add the pieces of meat to it, every good piece, the thigh and the shoulder, fill it with choice bones. Take the choice bone of the flock, heap up bones under it, boil rapidly, and boil its bones in it. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Woe to the city of bloodshed, the pot whose rot is in it, whose rot has not been removed from it. Empty it piece by piece. No lot has fallen on it, for her blood was in it. She poured it on an exposed rock. She did not pour it on the ground to cover it up with dust. To arouse anger, to take vengeance, I have placed her blood on an exposed rock so that it cannot be covered up. Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. Woe to the city of bloodshed. I will also make the pile high. Pile up the bones, kindle the fire. Cook the meat well, mix in the spices. Let the bones be charred. Set the empty pot on the coals until it becomes hot and its copper glows, until its uncleanliness melts within it and its rot is consumed. It has tried my patience, yet its thick rot is not removed from it. Subject its rot to the fire. You mix uncleanness with obscene conduct. I tried to cleanse you, but you were not clean. You will not be cleansed from your uncleanness until I have exhausted my anger on you. I, the Lord, have spoken. Judgment is coming, and I will act. I will not relent or show pity or be sorry. I will judge you according to your conduct and your deeds, declares the Sovereign Lord. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, realize that I'm about to take the delight of your eyes away from you with a jolt, but you must not mourn or weep or shed tears. Groan in silence for the dead, but do not perform mourning rites. Bind on your turban and put your sandals on your feet. Do not cover your lip and do not eat food brought by others. So I spoke to the people in the morning, and my wife died in the evening. In the morning, I acted just as I was commanded. Then the people said to me, "Will you not tell us what these things you are doing mean for us?" So I said to them, "The word of the Lord came to me. Say to the house of Israel, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Realize I am about to desecrate my sanctuary, the source of your confident pride, the object in which your eyes delight and your life's passion. Your very own sons and daughters whom you have left behind will die by the sword. Then you will do as I have done. You will not cover your lip or eat food brought by others. Your turbans will be on your heads and your sandals on your feet. You will not mourn or weep, but you will rot for your iniquities and groan among yourselves. Ezekiel will be an object lesson for you. You will do all that he has done. When it happens, then you will know that I am the sovereign Lord. And you, son of man, this is what will happen on the day I take from them their stronghold, their beautiful source of joy, the object in which their eyes delight, and the main concern of their lives, as well as their sons and daughters. On that day, a fugitive will come to you to report the news. On that day, you will be able to speak again. You will talk with the fugitives and be silent no longer. You will be an object lesson for them, and they will know that I am the Lord." It's kind of crazy, God, that we read things like this and we're like, oh yeah, I totally get it. Samaria and Jerusalem, you know, messed up and they were like prostitutes with all their idols and stuff like that. But the Bible really has nothing to do with my life, so it doesn't apply. This section where you're talking about they bathed and painted their eyes and decorated with jewelry and laid on a magnificent couch and used incense and olive oil, referring to all this prep time of getting ready for their lovers as a prostitute. And it does apply to us. And it hit really close to home, thinking about all the time we spent in our lives on things that have nothing to do with you, on things that have to do with our idols. And probably first and foremost that came to mind was work, of how much time, say we get, we spend getting ready for a presentation. Now, I'm not saying work's not important and we do have to make a living, but we spend so much time on a presentation for work, to give to bosses, to give to a client, to whatever that looks like. But in comparison, how much time do we spend on reading your word and talking to you? How much time do we spend on, once we've read that word, of applying it to our life? How much time do we spend going into the word past that and learning about the history and the people and the theology behind it? How often do we take that same Bible verses that we've read and talk about them with other people, be in a Bible study with them? Like, how much prep work do we actually do for our faith in comparison to some of the other things in our life? And it gets a little bit scary. I think if we sat down and kept a timetable of our day, let's say that we were like a lawyer and we had to keep track of every 15 minutes for billing purposes. Once we added up all of those minutes, how much of our day, minus the 8 hours of sleeping, how much of the rest of that day, those other 16 hours, would be spent on you, God? And I'm going to kind of guess that we're in the less than 1 hour out of 16 that most of us spend having to do with you. And it's a direct comparison to these prostitute sisters, of how much work and planning and preparation that they do for something that has nothing to do with you. You know, we do that for work, but we also, people like, oh, I have to work. True. But how much of that work, let's say that we work 8 hours, some of us way more than that, but let's say we work 10 hours. So out of 16 hours, that still leaves us 6 hours. how much of those 6 hours is actually spent on you, God? Well, we sure spend a lot of time picking out movies to go and watch, or texting our friends, or playing games online, or how much time every night do we spend on Facebook? All these things that have nothing to do with you, all of this prep time getting ready for our idols. God, your word applies to us so clearly. We just have to understand what you mean by it, what was going on at the time, and what does that look like in our lives? We might not have wooden idols, but I would say we actually have more idols now than they did in the past. Our idols of comfort and luxuriousness and adventure and entertainment. Work is definitely an idol for many people. Money is an idol. Relationships are idols. It just goes on and on, and truly prostitutes when we give our attention, our affection, our money to all of these other idols instead of you, God. And you're really clear in this story what happens to the prostitutes, what your plan of attack is for that. And you even go into a story about a pot that has corrupted the entire batch of food and how you plan on destroying that. God, we want our lives to be lived for you. We want to not be prostitutes of our idols. We want our walk to glorify you. We want our time here on earth to be about you and your plan for us. We don't want to waste it on idols. We don't want to waste it on things that don't matter. We don't want to waste it on things that are just going to burn up in that fire at the end of times. God, help guide our steps today. Help guide them in the path that you want us to walk. Make that path really clear and those options to us really clear. The world is a very attractive place, God. It's so easy to get consumed by stuff and getting ready for stuff and doing stuff and then talking about stuff. Allow us today to intentionally look at our lives and figure out how much of our time every day, how much of our 16 hours every day is truly spent with you, God. It's truly spent on your word and talking to you and sharing the gospel, and how much time is spent on being a prostitute. In your son's name I pray. Amen.